با عرض سلام و ادب خدمت تمام دوستان، امروز چهارمین رویداد جانبی ارگان غیر دولتی سودوین در 27مین نشست شورای حقوق بشر سازمان ملل در مورد اقلیت‌های مذهبی در ایران. ابتدا از خانم سیمین فهندش، نماینده جامعه جهانی بهایی در سازمان ملل در ژنو، تقاضا می‌کنم سخنرانی خود را با عنوان وضعیت کنونی بهاییان در ایران آغاز کنند. متشکرم.
Thank you very much for giving me the opportunity to speak here today. Unfortunately, the situation of religious minorities in Iran is still such that once again we have to gather here and provide updates on the new or ongoing forms of persecution that are happening to our fellow Iranians in Iran. According to the report of Mr. Ahmad Shahid, the Special Rapporteur on Iran, as of January 2014, at least 307 members of religious minorities were in detention, around 130 of whom were Baha'is, 90 were Sunni Muslims, 50 were Christians, 19 Dervish Muslims, 4 were Yarasanis, 2 Zoroastrians, and 6 were from other groups. As you know, Baha'is are not recognized in the Iranian constitution as an official religious minority, and so they have faced many levels of persecution since the Islamic Revolution. In the beginning years of the revolution, more than 200 Baha'is were executed, and since then hundreds more have been deprived of the right to higher education, of the right to work. Their children have faced discrimination at school, and they are imprisoned only because of their beliefs. Today, I would like to focus on one aspect of this persecution, which is the denial of the right to higher education, which is a quiet but very cruel way of trying to destroy a community by depriving the younger generation of not only being able to study and develop their potentials and capacities, but also taking away from them the ability to work, make a living, or contribute to their communities. Around a year ago, when President Rouhani came to power, he made many promises, one of which was that students who are eligible to attend universities will no longer be debarred from higher education because of their beliefs. And yet, sadly, still today, Baha'is are denied this right. And even worse, the government has changed its tactics so that it can more easily deny their actions when they are questioned by the international community about their discriminatory practices. In previous years, Baha'is who participated in the concours or the national examination, once the results were announced, they were faced with naqsa parvande or incomplete file. But this year, when they go to check the results, they are told that in order to receive the results, they must write to the local office of the Educational Measurement and Evaluation Organization, or Sanjish, which oversees the examination process. Many Baha'is have done this, and instead of receiving any satisfactory responses, they are told to go from one office to another, and they are shown a page in the examination booklet which states that only Muslims and officially recognized religious minorities are permitted to participate in the examination, which is of course completely contradictory to the statements that the Iranian officials make to the international community, that the reference to religion in the examination doesn't identify the applicant's religion, but it only specifies the religious subject that they choose to be tested on. A Baha'i youth who faced this problem asked one of the officials how he had been identified as a Baha'i since he had marked the religious subject that he wanted to study as Islam. And the official said that the religion of the individual had been inquired about and identified. And when this youth objected to this, he was told to take up the matter with the Ministry of Science. So he wrote letters pointing out his concerns, but he was told that the letter couldn't be registered because the content was considered to be related to security matters. So in this way, students are obstructed from even following up their cases and are given nothing in writing to indicate why they were not being accepted to university. And the computerized records that they receive don't give any evidence that it is because they have been identified as Baha'is that they're not admitted to university. And so this new tactic allows the government to deny Baha'i students the right to university without officially admitting the reason. What we need to understand is that these actions have been conducted as an official government policy by the Iranian government and as a systematic way to eliminate the Baha'i community as a viable entity. In 1991, a secret memorandum was found by UN Special Rapporteur, which was called the Baha'i Question or Mas'alei Baha'iyan. This memorandum, which was issued by the Supreme Leader Ayatollah Khamenei, established a policy at the quiet strangulation of the Baha'i community, and it essentially stated that Baha'is should be kept illiterate and uneducated, and they should be living only at a minimum level and fearful at every moment that even the tiniest infraction will bring the threat of imprisonment, or even worse. The central focus of this document was a call to treat Baha'is in such a way that their progress and development will be blocked. And the memorandum stated that Baha'is must be expelled from universities either in the admission process or during the course of their studies once it becomes known that they are Baha'is. So it is in this way that Baha'is have unjustly been denied the right to study in their own country. Education and acquiring knowledge is one of the most basic rights of every individual, and everyone should be given the freedom to work for it. The government of Iran is not only responsible for fulfilling its promises of equality and justice and implementing its obligations under international agreements, but it is also responsible as a government for maintaining the welfare and progress of its citizens and for taking into account their desire to learn, to study, to develop their potentials and work with others toward the betterment of their country. Thank you.